Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is Monday, the third day of December, 2012. I am Alex Jones, your host, and we are only 17 and a half days out from the planet Nibiru smashing into the planet and killing everyone, according to a lot of people out there that are what I would call fantasy fans. Who then go out and give conspiracy theorists a bad name. And that is what happens. There are a lot of people that don't trust what the system says, so then they just believe whatever they make up, like they're controlling reality. It's actually a step down from even what the New World Order is engaged in. They try to take reality and then distort it so that you're in their control system. But the people always saying that, you know, the Earth's going to end at this date and the Earth's going to end on that date. Amazing. So we've got a bunch of news on that today. And then, of course, the bad news. We knew it was coming, but the editor of the New Yorker magazine doesn't get more any insider than that with the Democratic Party. He's saying Hillary is going to run for president in 4 years. So that'll come quicker than you know, and I am not looking forward to Hillary. I guess that's kind of what Porter Stansbury is saying. The word is there's going to be so much oil money the government's going to have, the U.S. now being the biggest producer of oil in the world, that government's going to control that and be able to give drilling rights and other things to certain insiders, that because of that executive power over all those goodies that Putin's had, and we've seen Saudi Arabia have, and we've seen the dear leader, of Venezuela have, that it's going to be used to basically get a third term for Obama, kind of like what Teddy Roosevelt did. And we know they've had a congressman introduce legislation so Obama could run for a third time. And there's so much election fraud, and they probably put up another corpse, political corpse, to run up against him, that if it's not Obama for a third term, it'll basically be Hillary. So that will be her, let me see, one term, two term, three terms. Obama's getting a fourth term. And those were all really Clinton terms. So the Clintons are entering their fourth term right now. Obama is basically a Clinton front man. And so now, yeah, that'll be a fifth term for the Clintons. So very interesting. You know, George Herbert Walker Bush, for a great extent, was pretty much president in both Reagan administrations, especially after Reagan got shot, and then he had his term. So that was three terms for George Herbert Walker Bush. And then his son got two terms. So that's five terms for the Bushes. I think that's enough. I don't think we need Jeb Bush or anybody. And again, they're puppets of the globalists, but even though they're puppets, the bureaucracies that build up around them and the insiders, even within a corrupt centralized system, it's bad to have one group of criminal managers in there too long. I think it's good to rearrange deck chairs on the Titanic myself, just because of the aesthetics of it, maybe light a cigar. And Hillary is not lighting a cigar. Clinton is busy, her husband, using those. So it just kind of gives us a new enemy, a new puppet. But when it's these entrenched criminals that know where all the bodies are buried politically, they can really get pretty much anything they want done. Bob Costas has always been a sniveling New World Order minion. He used an editorial calling for restrictions on the guns as his pretext to push it, blaming the Second Amendment that another one of their NFL spoiled brat reported drug head punks killed himself and his girlfriend, that we should all have to turn our guns in. How about you go to the River Styx and cross over to hell, Costas, you little sniveling demon. You little elitist with your NFL propaganda machine selling us all your New World Order garbage. I mean, if that doesn't make you boycott the NFL, nothing will. We'll be right back. You like the New World Order? You like losing all your basic rights and liberties, like your currency being devalued? You like private world government running the UN, announcing $100 trillion in new global taxes they want? You like the megabanks exempt from all laws and taxes? The EU bureaucrats exempt from taxes they hoist and foist on their own people? Well, that's the model of the world that we are going into. By the way, we need to get the lead singer and founder of, who's a listener, the group we were just playing, Ministry, on, because he thinks the world is going to end December 21st, 2012. And I know there's a lot of reasons people think that. There's also kind of a romanticism about the end of the world. I don't think it's very romantic. And I'm going to publish an article either this afternoon or tomorrow with Paul Watson. What that means is Paul records me talking, and then he goes and does his own research and adds to it. And then we put an article together dealing with the reasons and the proof that the world is not going to be ending. And obviously now the hype over this is starting to really reach a crescendo. And so what does the doomsday clock say according to Pacific time? We've got how many days left of the end of the world? 17 days. Oh, 17 days, 6 hours, 49 minutes, 33 seconds. But that is in that time zone. So it varies when they say the Nibiru is going to crash into us. Others say the galaxy is going to flip on its edge, or there's going to be a pole shift or any of that. So I will be talking about that later in the broadcast, because Duma, that's the Russian Congress, begs TV stations not to encourage end-of-the-world hysteria. Scientists assert there will be no end of the world. Well, at least not then. And so I'm going to do some reports this week, too, talking about why this is a hoax and won't be the end of the world, but real things that could end the world. In fact, I keep intending, I was even going to make a film about this years ago and got started on it, but just so busy with the TV show and the films that we do daily and the research and the radio show, I never got around to it. But here we are, so I'm going to make a report this week on that subject. Also, we've got a bunch of big stuff this week on the radio broadcast. John Bowne and crew have taken the entire Ron Paul farewell address and added news articles and video clips to it, backing up everything Ron Paul talks about. And so now it is a film on its own with his 48-minute speech and then change. It is going to be powerful. I don't know what we're going to call it. We're going to premiere it Wednesday night on the nightly news, 7 o'clock Central, InfoWarsNews.com. And then I will also play excerpts of it for the TV viewers and radio listeners here on, well, Alex Jones Live. That's what we call the weekday radio show, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. When I got into talk radio 17 years ago and then got syndicated, I don't know, in 1997, late 1997, we had to go with the name of the show. And the way Arbitron works at the time is you want to have your name in the name of the show, because that's what people then hear. And so then if you want to show ratings for your affiliates, you've got to do that. So it's called The Alex Jones Show. But affiliates now, you know, send us what they want me to plug in little promo pieces. I think the consensus is the radio show is called InfoWars. And that's what I wanted to call it 17 years ago. But it just basically ended up becoming the Alex Jones Show. And then we call it on PrisonPlanet.tv or InfoWarsNews.com. If you go there, just a factoid, we call the three-hour radio show each day Alex Jones Live, because it is the live show. Some nights the TV show is live. A lot of nights it is a bunch of interviews and research and news we shoot, and then that's taped, but then we'll come back live. And then some nights it is entirely live or entirely taped, as you have seen. We are planning more live stuff in the future, and we're nailing down satellite information and file sharing information and different things to try to get it on more cable and TV. So that's exciting. I'm kind of segueing off here into almost a corporate minutes of the InfoWars operation here. Because my brain tends to just idle off into whatever area that I focus and consciously look into. I think we're all that way. But I think it's also a form of procrastination as I sit here looking at over 200 news articles, all of which are incredibly important. So let me just do this. Let me just give you a smattering of what's coming up here. Vatican introduces new security measures as the Vatican leak scandal intensifies. And it is microchip tracker IDs. And if the Vatican is accepting microchip identification, no wonder Discover and MasterCard and Visa are all going to thumbprint paying, where soon you won't even be able to pay with a card, or if you do, they're going to demand fingerprint certification. And then they'll just segue into pure face scan and thumbprint. You'll pay with your face or your hand. I seem to have heard of that someplace, but you can argue either the Bible's true and is actually starting to happen, or you could argue it's really good science fiction, you know, written in the last 2,000 plus years of the New Testament, Old Testament, 3,000 plus years, much of it, and that bad guys went and read it and said, this is a great idea. But you can't argue that it's happening. certainly is happening. Also, I saw a story today out of the London Telegraph dealing with their IRS, Her Majesty's Revenue and Customs is what it's called. And it's modeled, our IRS is modeled after that. It has pretty much the exact same rules. And I walked into it, Don Salazar and Kurt Nemo, and I said, you know, guys, that the IRS is doing this now under Patriot Act compliance, and it's a total violation of your Fourth Amendment. I said, just go look up the fact that the IRS is watching people's bank accounts through Know Your Customer and suspicious transaction reports. But that's just the surface. They're dialed into your bank accounts. It's part of why there's so much fraud. You've got government agents stealing data for themselves, selling it to mafia groups, you name it. They give unlimited fake well, not fake, they're real, but they give it to fake identities, tax ID numbers to get tax returns and things, sometimes tens of millions per household. No one gets in trouble because it's being fenced into mafia groups. I mean, you don't think when they have, you know, some homes getting $80-plus million dollars or $10 million, and you saw those reports a few months ago, you don't think no one's being prosecuted just because they want to let the family keep that money. That's being fenced through mafia into mega banks that launder the money. You don't think the $500 billion a year in narcotics money going through the U.S., it's over a trillion worldwide every year. Yeah, the United States uses about half the drugs in the world, and we're 5% of the population. Wow. That is illegal drugs. We are just absolutely bombed out of our brains on average. We drink more alcohol than anybody in the world, even the Russians, on average now. But side issue, just little factoids there for you. Continuing here with the mafia government, lock your doors and prepare to defend your family. That's a new article by Michael Schneider from Economic Collapse blog we have up at InfoWars.com. And he says, do you think that's an alarmist headline? Well, I am not the one saying this. Yeah, that's right. It came out last week. That is the county attorney and people there in San Bernardino. Shame the government can't protect you. Protect yourself. The city attorney of San Bernardino, California, told citizens. And it's a good article. I want to tie it into. No, the world's not going to end December 21st, but the good in the world, the justice in the world, is dying the death of a trillion cuts. And they are many, many tens of billions of cuts into this process, and it's only going to get worse until we stop being so decadent. I think that's the central point that Ron Paul made during his speech. Some of the other news here, veteran journalist describes sexual assault rape at the hands of TSA. Karen Kaplan, she's the editor, one of the editors over there at the Journal of Nature, and has been there 20 years and is highly respected. Yeah, when people go in your pants and in your body, it's rape. But it's to keep you safe from Al-Qaeda, the government publicly runs and is giving Libya and Syria. By the way, maybe I need a document cam shot on this. Right over here is a good spot. I think we've decided on this area as the document cam shot. We've kind of changed the studio around a little bit. Street artist behind satirical NYPD drone posters arrested. And free speech is the absolute most protected thing. And doing it physically is the paramount. And the person to get attention went with their friends and put a few of these up in the poster kiosks over government propaganda that the government uses our tax money against us in New York. And they've arrested them. They have now arrested the street artist. And it shows an image of a drone, and it says NYPD, and it shows the drone firing a missile at a running family. And it's those illegal alien crossing signs they have. I used to think that was a joke till I saw some in Arizona, because the illegals are running across the highways. You know, the woman holding the little kid with the ponytail running. And it shows the missile going after him, because they are getting weaponized drones. But don't worry, they've arrested him like it's the Soviet Union. Coming up, the editor of the New Yorker magazine, that is super insider, top of the Democratic Party food chain in New York, says Hillary is going to run for president. So we're going to be getting into that PrisonPlanet.com report. Watson found the YouTube video of that. We're breaking that at Infowars.com. Also, veteran journalist describes sexual assault. As I mentioned, we're going to get into that. Morsi, the Muslim Brotherhood and the globalist plan for Africa and the Middle East, why they're putting Muslim extremists in charge and dictators everywhere while calling it freedom. That is all coming up. Finishing up on the drones, then I'm going to get into the Second Amendment. This is going to backfire on the NYPD. I mean, the gentleman put up a couple posters, Assam Atta, showing a predator drone firing a missile. It's very tastefully done, because it shows the family running. It's just black silhouettes on a gray background. And it says, NYPD drones. A street artist who hung satirical posters criticizing police surveillance activity has been arrested after the NYPD investigation tracked him to his doorstep. Wish they could track folks to the doorstep of the rapists and robbers and killers in New York with their high crime rate. Same thing in Chicago, but they can only seem to confiscate law-abiding citizens' guns. With the help of a small crew, the artist, now identified as Assam Atta, we're going to get him on the show, had placed the fake Big Brother-style adverts in locations throughout Manhattan using a fake Van Wagner maintenance van and uniforms to avoid detection. In the video, boy, that'd be great documentary to make show I'm doing that. In a video interview with Animal New York prior to his arrest, a voice scrambled and silhouetted. Atta explained that he placed the provocative ads to create a conversation about disturbing trends in police surveillance, alluding to recent efforts by the Department of Homeland Security to facilitate and accelerate the adoption of unmanned aerial drones by police departments. Sure, and they're now arming them, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so that's an article out of TheVerge.com. Here is the Washington Post this weekend. This weekend, drone crashes mount at civilian airports. Folks, I saw just a few weeks ago in my truck, and it was flying over me, so I almost ran off the road trying to pull over to get it, and it was already gone. But the point is, I saw undoubtedly a Global Hawk at what looked like stall speeds, because those are supposedly jet engines. And I've been in Cessnas. My dad's a pilot. You see when a Cessna's flying into the wind, it's going like 60 miles an hour. This was going a little faster, maybe 100. And I looked at it, and I'm like, that's a Global Hawk. And I got to the office, typed it in. Yeah, that's a unmarked white Global Hawk. I've seen a highway department drone. I got it on tape, pulled over, and I was able to get it on tape and find the controller. Crew around here have been running into drones. But here it is. Drone crashes mounted civilian airports. The U.S. Air Force drone on a classified spy mission over the Indian Ocean was destined for disaster from the start. An inexperienced military contractor in shorts and a T-shirt flying by remote control from a trailer at the Seychelles International Airport committed a blunder after its 6 minutes. In 6 minutes on April 4th, he sent the unmanned MQ-9 Reaper drone off without permission from the control tower. A minute later, he yanked the wrong lever of his control, killing the engine without realizing why. And now the $8.9 million aircraft belly flopped. And then it just goes through all these other crashes of drones and drones over Denver, almost colliding with aircraft. I mean, let me tell you, I've flown into Chicago before, O'Hare, and looked out the window and they had a circling and there were three planes stacked up in circling right beside us. I mean, one had to be, let's not exaggerate, 400 yards away. I mean, everyone was like, oh, you could hear the gasp and the, and then there were other planes stacked out by it. We don't need robots flying around, but I'm going to tell you what's going to happen. There are going to be more and more drone problems, and then they're going to, they're already saying this is their plan, make all of your aircraft. In fact, England last week launched its first test of pilotless passenger planes, BBC reported. They're now doing the test. Decades ago, they flew planes from Los Angeles to Australia and back, jumbo jets. That's why when 9/11 happened and I said they were clearly remote control aircraft, people are like, they don't have that technology. Folks, they had drones in World War II, but I digress. And then here's another report here. Drone makers push Congress to move up domestic deployment date, the Center for Responsive Politics, and they want them weaponized. And they've already got House members in California, Texas, and Virginia and New York on bipartisan drone caucus. And the governor of Virginia wants armed drones. It's all happening. Don't criticize it, though, or you'll get arrested.
Into this world we're thrown.
Monday through Friday, 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern. We are here, my friends. And if we give the New World Order a ride, sweet ma'am, we will die. There is a killer on the road. His brain is squirming like a toad. Take a long holiday. Let your children play. All right, it's hard to not listen to that poetry. We are back live here, finishing up with the drone. This is so disgusting. I didn't even get to the key part here. They had months of counterterrorism investigations. The NYPD's response seems to have proven the artist's point months after forensics teams and a counterterrorism unit, that's from a press release from the police department, unit was spotted on the scene. The NYPD last Wednesday successfully tracked down and arrested the 29-year-old art school vandal who identified himself in the video as a former geospatial analyst serving U.S. military operations in Iraq. It's not the first time the NYPD has overreacted to unsanctioned public art. Earlier this year, the department arrested a 50-year-old gentleman after he illuminated the streets of Williamsburg, Brooklyn, with harmless LED pattern made from plastic I Heart New York shopping bags. Yeah, all over the world, street art is honored. And even political graffiti back to the time of Rome, you didn't touch it. But they hate this idea of street art. They hate the idea that it will be written on the walls. The prophets write it on the subway walls. What song is that? There's a famous song where, and it's written that it will be written on the subway walls. It'll pop in my head in a moment. The point is, that's why we've had, I don't know, 6-7 contests to go and put just little posters up. The Sounds of Silence, Simon and Garfunkel. Maybe we should go out to break with just that section if you guys can find it. Thank you. My brain's all over the place today. My point is that this can bring down the New World Order. People really pay attention to even just a normal, you know, office paper size printout. What is this, 8x10? People really pay attention to this with something like, read the insert on vaccines. It's poisonous. And there were hundreds of local TV stations around the country freaking out. and calling us when our listeners hung those up all over the nation a few years ago during the fake flu crisis, and reporters from Dallas and Chicago and New York and everywhere in between would call me and say, are you afraid you're going to be arrested for telling people to do this, lying and saying vaccines are poisonous? And I'd say, no, I mean, it's my First Amendment. It says they have thimerosal mercury in them. It says on the insert it can cause neurological disorders. All I'm doing is saying if people through free association agree with what I'm saying, whoever shoots the best video of these posters being hung up, that way it's on cyberspace and physically, that way we cover full spectrum. We're physically getting people to do stuff to wake folks up, but we're also then physically uploading it, you know, shooting video of it, uploading it. People are then seeing it and going out and becoming physical. It's using the internet to get people back out there in the real world. And I'll say to the reporters, to the point of I didn't have time to call them all back, so I just gave a standard, you know, info to my crew, and they would talk to them and end up being recorded and put on local news around the country about, well, have you read an insert? And a lot of the newscasts, they would go, we actually did what Infowars.com recommended, and it's true. It says it can cause cancer, neurological disorders, or even death. Turns out the signs, though you can debate whether they're legal to hang, were actually telling the truth. You know, some of the reports were positive. It's like the Obama Joker poster contest, which, by the way, I'm bringing back. I want to launch a second one in the new year with new posters we design. We'll have a contest on the best poster, but also we'll have a contest, because he is dictator Obama now on every front. We're going to go over that coming up today. And we're going to have a contest of putting Obama posters up again. Even though he's a puppet dictator, a viceroy of the globalist, his office is being turned into a veritable tyrant's command center. The law is dead to a great extent. And if we roll over to this takeover, Katie, bar the door. You think things are bad? You ain't seen nothing yet, as they say. So we have this report here, and it goes on to anti-terrorism arrest of people, I Heart New York. That'll get you arrested for terrorism or by the terrorism squad. He now faces 56 counts of criminal possession of forged instrument and grand larceny possession of stolen property for his spree last September. This happened a couple months ago with an additional charge of weapons possession after officers, not servants, allegedly found an unloaded .22 caliber revolver under his bed during the raid. Yeah, can't have a gun in New York, buddy. As for the drones themselves, the NYPD has still not received any plans to use aerial robotic enforcers. That's not true. The FAA's authorized it, and they're moving forward with it. As documented use of drones by local police in Texas, Fox News. So it goes on from there. There you go. And they're proliferating everywhere. It's the militarization of America. And that's why this weekend, drones to take over the skies of Austin. I'm going to have my crew retweet this article from last Friday, because I should have plugged it, November 29th. Announcing the first ever InfoWars drone mob and video contest. If I don't tweet this during the next break, will you remind me to have the crew do it? Oh, my tweets are mine. Sometimes I kind of dictate them. And by the way, we need to get our Twitter numbers up. I got to Twitter late, and we're more of a conservative libertarian audience who's not known for tweeting and Twitter. I told Charlie Sheen, I said, you got to get a Twitter account. He got one. He got 8 million users. I was the guy who got Charlie Sheen to get a tweet. I said, man, you're always going to TMZ to get the word out or something, or me. I said, do it through Twitter. Literally, we had that conversation. I'm not name dropping. It happened. You know, he flew in this big private jet to pick me up. I'm like, Charlie, you don't need to fly out here to pick me up when I come out to your house. He lands this wide body jet. I get on, and we have this big discussion about Twitter, and he went and set up his Twitter. But that's how Charlie Sheen got on Twitter. True story. I need to still tweet some of those photos, but never even got around. You know why? Because I got a droid. It didn't work very well. I didn't know how to use it. I guess I'm used to Apple. And then we moved, and then the droid is in a box somewhere in the storage building. So that's where all those great photos are, but some really great photos. But I'm not really a gossip show, so I'll shut up now. Drones to take over the skies of Austin, announcing the first ever InfoWars drone mob and video contest. InfoWars is announcing the first ever drone mob event on Saturday, December 8th, 2012, at Zilker Park, 2010 Barton Springs Road in Austin, Texas. And today we'll get out a map of where I think we're going to meet up and everything. Yeah. 2100 Barton Springs Road in Austin, Texas. We're going to do it out in that big field, in the big Zilker field by the river, out there by the soccer fields. And there's no FAA regulations below 400 feet. And so everybody out there, we're going to invite local businesses that are drone operators out there. In fact, I've got that guy's card somewhere that was working for the highway department. Will you guys dig that out? Because I don't know where it's at now. And I want to call and invite him out. I want to invite everybody out to operate their RC aircraft, folks. But the difference is police departments are getting these with cameras to watch us. And they're bragging that they're using satellites to surveil us, to enforce property taxes and environmental rules. You've seen those ads where they go, Tom, we do know where you are. You live at, and then it shows the satellite zooming in on his house. The point is that now they've got switchblade drones that they put a pound of plastic explosive in the nose of them and then fly them out, you know, to go into your front door. And then you've got all the big high-tech drones and reapers and the rest of them. And this is the robot takeover rollout is why I talk so much about it. This is the globalist program of domination. And so drones are being pushed as fanciful, but it's going to be ground robots, undersea robots. They're now talking about robot fish that are going to be in the lakes used by the police to surveil you, to swim up to your house and watch you. That was mainstream news last week. They only cost about $1,000. And can go around for days solar powered and then come back. They can program a robot fish. It's about 4 feet long. It goes out silently with a little tail motion, comes up to your house with cameras, videotapes what you're doing, audio scissors as well, and goes down the line surveilling backyards for pot plants, whatever the case is, Homeland Security grants. This is in the news last week. And we're going to pay to have police launching these into rivers and streams and all over the country. Per state, they're getting, in states like Texas, is more than 20 gunboats with high-powered full-auto machine guns to be on lakes and rivers, not just the borders. So it's just a full rollout. Yeah, there it is, RoboCop. Homeland Security adds underwater drones to their arsenal of robots based on fish. Yeah, there it is. There's the RoboTuna, unmanned underwater vehicle, and then you can go read what the police are calling for. It's cameras and the rest of it. And I may come down there. You know, my children look at me every week and they go, you know, you even work on Saturday now. And it's not that they're guilting me. It really is. We have a lot of fun together. Playing laser tag in the yard and going fishing and going hiking and painting and wrestling. And so that's why I've decided to go ahead and put my 8-year-old daughter and 10-year-old son on air. I may even go whole hog and get the 4-year-old on. Give them jobs. They all want to come up here. And be on air, and they're all really talented and funny. But maybe that's the answer, is to have my children at work a few days a week. My son is chomping at the bit. We're going to do a piece with lasers breaking down directed energy weapons very soon. It's going to be directed by my 10-year-old son. Frustration is I got to stand back and let him actually direct it. But he's come up with some really great ideas, so we're working on that. But if I do go out there Saturday, I'm going to bring my children. So maybe I won't go now that I've announced that. Jakari Jackson, Melissa Melton, Darren McBreen, they're all going to be out there. InfoWars is announcing the first ever drone mob event Saturday, December 8th, 2012 at Zilker Park. The Federal Aviation Administration has announced there may be 30,000 drones over America's skies for 2020, government drones, and now Congress is actually pushing the FAA to hand drone oversight to the Department of Homeland Security, which is taking over everything, and it's not the federal government, it's the banker occupation government. And so we're going to have a $1,000 prize on the best video filmed from the event. Need not even have a drone there, and we'll announce that before Christmas, who the winner is of that. It'll take time to review all the videos. So everybody, come, This Saturday. I am not announcing the exact time. It'll be sometime afternoon. I'll announce that later. There at Zilker Park in Austin, Texas, and we're also going to call them the mainstream dinosaur media and invite them out to that as well. And the hashtag is Drone Mob. So be sure and follow us over at twitter.com/RealAlexJones. And I think there's an at something we need to get to. I never really pay attention to Twitter, but now I use it so much. I like to send out photos, wildlife photos, Interesting breaking news. It's really important everybody follow me at twitter.com/realalexjones. And it's really important everybody follow what we're doing over at the newsletter, which we only send out about once a month right now. And we're going to send it out tomorrow with the free digital version of InfoWars magazine that is now sold out except for some that we've held back for subscriptions. Well, technically, and now I segue off into this, we'll give folks a document cam shot of that over there. I print a little over 100,000 of these, and we normally put about 70,000 on the street. But within a day, we sold out of the 20-something thousand we were holding back to sell in bulk, and then had the 5,000 we were holding back for any new subscriptions that came in this month. So what I did is, luckily, a truck hadn't delivered 10,000 to San Antonio yet, so I pulled that truck and didn't distribute in San Antonio. I was going to start that as a test, because people really are waking up down in San Antonio, or they're hungry for it. And then I ended up, there was 5,000 hadn't been delivered yet in Austin, so I pulled those. So now I have an additional 5,000, but they're going so fast. The 10,000 sold out over the weekend I pulled. The 5,000 will be gone, I would imagine, by tonight or tomorrow. So if you want to buy them in groups of 10 up to 100, at cost, that is at cost, you can buy them. And it's the This Man Wants Your Guns Obama issue. It also has Ron Paul's full text of his farewell address, incredible information, 60 pages, glossy magazine. It's not in newsprint now, at InfoWarsStore.com. And I'm really excited about the magazine because it gets the word out. You can also get a one-year subscription and give it as a gift to get 12 issues delivered to your friends or family's door, or the police station's door, or the local library. And then also we have a new U.S. Army style that's in that font, in the gold font that the Oath Keepers use. We have a new InfoWars.com gold on black t-shirt that my wife thinks is the best ever. I ask her what she thinks of stuff, designs I come up with, and a new InfoWars Oath Keeper style. I say that, Oath Keepers is U.S. Army style, so we're just taking the U.S. Army style. Black and gold hat, along with the InfoWars camo and the InfoWars Hunter orange. Those are all available at InfoWarsStore.com. And even though these hats and t-shirts really don't make us much money to fund the operation, I'm most excited about them because when you wear an InfoWars.com ball cap, or especially a big bold t-shirt, you will meet like-minded people big time. I don't care where you are in the English-speaking world, and even not in the English-speaking world. You want to meet like-minded people, it's like, you know, wearing your colors or something. So the new t-shirt, a bunch of other great t-shirts, Live Free or Die, you name it. Camo, InfoWars, Live Free or Die shirts as well, InfoWarsStore.com, and the yearly membership. And lastly, your Christmas shopping is over. You buy one InfoWars, Nightly News, my films, all my book, Paul Watson's book, dozens of other films, 9+ years up and operating. You get a PrisonPlanet.tv membership for $5.95 a month. 10 people can use the same username and passcode. So create an original username passcode, put it in an e-file, send it to everybody and say, here's your gift. Buy yourself a gift and then give other people the gift. In an e-card or in a physical card, here's your PrisonPlanet.tv membership. 10 memberships, 59 cents a day per person, and that just pays for the bandwidth. This is a huge opportunity, PrisonPlanet.tv, to do all your Christmas shopping for 10 people. You can get it all done right now, PrisonPlanet.tv. We'll be right back. And that leads us to our next report. Bob Costas, after the Kansas City Chiefs linebacker, Jovan Belcher, kills girlfriend, takes his own life, reportedly hopped up on drugs, alcohol, a 25-year-old spoiled brat, goes and kills himself in front of his coaches. She should have had a gun to protect herself from him. Are we going to ban knives when people stab their wives? What about when troops come home after 6-7 tours and kill their family? Going to ban guns then because you push those people too far? You got these NFL people with all these concussions and the rest of it? Bunch of spoiled brats who really think they're God and buy into all the hype. And what does Bob Costas do? He starts quoting news articles calling to restrict my guns because your decadent gladiator was a big fat baby. Let's go ahead and play Bob Costas. Here it is.
From the Kansas City-based writer Jason Whitlock. with whom I do not always agree, but who today said it so well that we may as well just quote or paraphrase from the end of his article. Our current gun culture, Whitlock wrote, ensures that more and more domestic disputes will end in the ultimate tragedy, and that more convenience store confrontations over loud music coming from a car will leave more teenage boys bloodied and dead. Handguns do not enhance our safety. They exacerbate our flaws, tempt us to escalate arguments, and bait us into embracing confrontation rather than avoiding it. In the coming days, Javon Belcher's actions and their possible connection to football will be analyzed. Who knows? But here, wrote Jason Whitlock, is what I believe. If Javon Belcher didn't possess a gun, he and Cassandra Perkins would both be alive today.
There you go. Let me give you a news flash, punk. Not everybody makes $10 million a year like you. Not everybody can live in big armored gated communities and have bodyguards like you and Dianne Feinstein and Barbara Boxer and Chucky Schumer and Sarah Brady and all of you people that are on record having guns. Okay? How dare you not focus on why society is degenerating and then try to take my guns? Only a punk coward would use a gun on his girlfriend. Only a piece of garbage. And because he's bad, I need to have my guns taken? Hey, listen, great cities like New York and Chicago, where they've banned citizens' right to own guns, where they arrest political activists for a .22 handgun, they are places where everyone has lost their right to defend themselves, and they have the highest crime rates. That's unbelievable. He could have stabbed her. He could have broke her neck. If there wasn't a gun, this wouldn't have happened. Bull. Now, look right here. Here's the local Chronicle. Anti-gun, anti-hunting, anti-everything. Going out for dinner. Learning the responsibilities and rewards of getting your own game at a hunting school for women. And it's a pro-hunting article. It's over. The liberals that I know are all buying guns. They're getting into hunting. They're figuring out it's domestication. The feminists are figuring it out. You're losing. The gun culture's winning.
Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
By the way, when somebody wants to ban your guns, they are your absolute enemy. Because once they get the guns, they've got the military and police trained that the founding fathers are bad and all the rest of it. They're coming after us. And this world is ruled by violence, as Bob Dylan was saying in the last segment. And so we need the physical threat of defense to hold back the ravenous criminals on the street, but also government. And as it becomes evident that government can't and won't protect you in Hurricane Sandy or Katrina, as people see disarmed populations murdered in Africa and you name it, and people learn about Mao Zedong taking the guns and killing everybody and saying political power grows out of a barrel of a gun. People are out buying guns. That's why this article I'm going to cover later, lock your doors, prepare to defend your family. You know, that's what the police are starting to say because they live in the real world. Despite all the brainwashing the globalists give them, all the federalization, the longer police are policed statistically, the better they get on average because they start living in the real world. They start becoming reassured when there's a robbery going on and the guy jumps over somebody's fence and the cop can't find him in the dark and a citizen says, put your hands up, and the cop's able to arrest him. Police are living in the real world. And so that's why I've seen national studies. We've had Jack McClam on about this. We've also had the head of Gun Owners of America on about it. Larry Pratt, I mean, I've seen national studies and polls of police where 98% are pro-gun. Well, I mean, they're around guns all day. They're not afraid of guns anymore. And that's how we're going to beat these people. And if we beat them on guns and we're getting close, we beat them on everything. And I need to do a special report on this sometimes. In fact, before the year ends, I'm going to do a special report that we're winning the war against tyranny in that one area. But folks, you win in one area and we ever overturn them in any area, they fall. So we are winning the gun war. Need to do a report on that. That is essential that I do that. And also I want to do a report on the end of the world being a hoax. But it could happen. This particular, this is the end of the world, is just a total hoax. But it could happen. So I want to look at real threats. And when we come back, I'm going to give the number out on Bob Costas. You know, it sounds like, oh, don't be mean to Bob Costas. People really become friends with their football commentators. I got a lot of heat last year, day one, when I said, you know, the whole university heads were involved in the cover-up because it came on the local news. It wasn't national. And you know they're running kids out of Pedophile Valley there at Penn State. You know, Black Sunshine. What's the real name of it? Sunny Valley? Yeah. Black Sunshine Valley, Devil Valley, Satanic Valley. Of course it's hooked into politicians and people. Of course it turned out it was hooked into Homeland Security. Of course it's hooked into all sorts of sooty groups. I mean, Sandusky was raping children inside of the facility, in front of people, at, you know, in the middle of the day, in public places. And that showed right there, oh my gosh, this was covered up from the mid-90s. It fit the MO of how they run these charities of disadvantaged, at-risk kids so nobody will believe them. And we've seen this over and over again all over the world. The globalists want power so they can do bad things. Maybe it's kill young women. A lot of them are into that. Maybe it's kill young men, like John Wayne Gacy. Maybe it's hurt little children. But they crave the power so they can do the crime and exempt themselves under national security. And so that's why I get mad at the churches trying to act like they're on a high horse after somebody's sexual activities that are consensual with adults, because it's all this obsession over that and never over the real abuse and bad things and killing that's going on. You know, they'll never touch the stuff that Cynthia McKinney in Congress would expose. And then half the time, those preachers are the biggest freaks out there. They're just total hypocrites is my issue. We'll be right back. Stay with us. We are now into the second hour of this worldwide broadcast. And we have got so much news we're going to hit and cover here. New York editor, the editor of New Yorker magazine, Hillary Clinton is running for president. We're going to break that down. Duma begs TV stations not to encourage end-of-the-world hysteria in Russia. But I'm going to tie it into real threats facing society and a headline, lock your doors and prepare to defend your family. That's what police and city attorneys are saying all over the country. Also, the Vatican goes big brother with RFID tracker chips. We're going to get more into Bob Costas and his attack on the Second Amendment in the aftermath of the NFL player reportedly drugged out of his mind, running around in a pity party with himself. Maybe it's the concussions, who knows? PTSD, how about just, you know, being a wimp, being an idiot? Continuing here, we're going to get into Turkey fears Syria chemical weapons, seeks NATO missiles. So what we've been saying for months, they're going to have a false flag on Syria, saying they've used chemical weapons, then have NATO fully invade to back up the Al-Qaeda forces they've had attacking them for 21 months. Unbelievably immoral. And you can only do this with Western countries that are in comas. You know, give your rights up because of Al-Qaeda, but the government runs Al-Qaeda. Just, and I'd even talk to good old boys that are engineers, scientists, and they go, Alex, I know what you're saying. I know it's true, but I just can't respond. I just don't know what to say. What do we do? It's just like, okay, the government runs Al-Qaeda to take our liberty. It's completely obvious. They've been running them the entire time. They're running them now, and I've still got to have some TSA person come up and go, where are you going? What are you doing? What are you doing when you get to that city? And I'm like, come on, you know who I am, don't you? I saw you run over here all excited. Don't be a troublemaker, Jones. Of course I know who you are. And I'm just like, man, you really are a lowlife. This happened flying out the last two times. Two different guys came over. Both times doing their behavioral analysis. You become TSA with a two-week course. You take another eight-hour course, and you can now read minds. And they decide if you get to fly now. They decide if you're bad. It's just bestowing themselves. Now, if you go back in the prop room real quick, there when you first come in, there's a magic wand. Somebody mailed me, because I used to do this joke with a pen, and I'd say, Al Gore waves his magic wand and says he invented the internet. TSA waves their magic wand and says they've got to stick their hands down your pants. It's against the law, but they wave it. And so now, oh, I had an eight-hour course smiling or frowning or sweating or not sweating or being talkative, being friendly. These are in the police training manuals, too, that Homeland Security gives them. Police are all nodding their heads. You've all been in the meetings. You've been giving it. If someone avoids you or someone smiles at you or someone is nice to you. And so many times I've walked up to cops and, hey, how's it going? Nice night, huh? Well, I'm waiting, you know, with my wife and the kids are in the bathroom. This just happened a few weeks ago, and the cops start looking at me, and then they even knew who I was. One of them was like, you're Alex Jones, and like they were just kind of paranoid, I guess. But, oh, yeah, here it is. I was mailed this. I was mailed this by a listener, and it says, Man, Bear, Pig, Al Gore's magic wand. Wave it a couple of times, and you save the earth. CO2 problem. I forget who it was, but it was Lord Monckton, I think. Yeah, it was Lord Monckton. And he was in studio like 6 months ago, and this has just been mailed to me. So it was sitting down on the floor. And he's like, what is this? And I'm like, oh, it's just a wand someone mailed me. Let's not look at that. It just looked like total fruit basket land. But here it is. And so you go take an eight-hour course, and you can now read minds, tell if someone's lying. Which just means they get to now say, I've chosen you can't fly. I've chosen you can't fly. And the really fun part about it is, I've told the story of flying back to Texas last year, and the guy was like, come with me. You're getting a pat down. He goes, you don't have to fly. This is my administrative, exact quote was my administrative right. And he was smiling and excited. He goes, I listened to your show. I listened yesterday. And I was just like, I mean, I kind of took it the way the guy was acting, that I looked like Marilyn Monroe or something to him. You know, the way Marilyn Monroe would look to me. And it was just this country so far gone. But it's run by psych warfare people. So it's all about what can we get them to accept? Because if they take us a million miles into bizarre tyranny, even if we fight back 500,000 miles, we're still there. So it's like tying 15 bowling balls to somebody, even if they're the best swimmer in the world. You chain to shackles 15 big bowling balls to Phelps, the Olympic swimmer, you know, greatest ever, and throw him off into the Atlantic Ocean. Folks, he's dead. Phelps is going to the bottom. And so they put like 100 bowling balls on us, and we're trying to get them off, and they're going, oh, there's no bowling balls. We're like, yeah, they're announcing world government. They're announcing that they're going to shut down the major roads and double our power prices and have all these new taxes, and here's your own documents where you admit this is your plan to make us dependent on the state because you're scared of the free market wealth. That socialist collectivists want to wreck wealth for the general public because it's all about control, because you're very nasty people. No, we're not setting any of that up, crazy person. Everything's fine. Just go to sleep. It's like in 2001 Space Odyssey where they're talking to Hal and they know he's lying to them. It's like, no, doctor, I don't know about that problem. I don't know what you're talking about. It's like when an employee, you've caught them lying to you five or six times, and you've caught them like in the sixth time, and you know they're lying, and they still lie, and they're lying, smiling at you, lying to your face, and you're just looking at them, and or it's like a neighbor you catch lying to you. I mean, at a certain point, you know, out of my life. Well, I can't, see, finally, I've grown up to the point where people act weird, act strange, act envious, act bizarre, act neurotic. They're out of my life. Not that I'm perfect. It's just that the luxury in my life is not being around people that act weird. I'm just not there. I'm looking up into the stars, into the universe, into science, into discovery, into things I want to do. I live an empowered, incredibly exciting, full life. And I'm not like up here bragging I do. I want you to stop caring what people think about you. Stop caring about approval from the establishment, because it's all a distortion. And start caring about what makes sense to your gut. And that is what everything good flows from. And I don't know how I got off into this whole story. The point is that, oh, yeah, people go, well, I know the government runs al-Qaeda now. That's admitted, but it just people aren't ready to hear it. Well, they better be ready to hear it because they're going to use this to take everything we've got. They want to get rid of the Bill of Rights and Constitution. They're doing a darn good job of it with a wrecking ball right now. The president is saying he's above the law on the military, taxes, regulations, power plants. The TSA says they don't have to go before congressional committees, that they're above the law. They're saying they're above the law on internet censorship and control, and the order's secret, and Congress can't see it. I mean, Congress should be impeaching Obama right now, but the special interests that are financing the heads of the committees are the same ones financing Obama and the same ones financing Mitt Romney. So they've got, it's like a craps table where you buy, you put money on every single space. If the payout isn't set right, the House is going to lose money. He basically can't lose. They've got money on every single space. It'd be like a roulette wheel if you pick red and black and every number. Or it'd be like if you bought lottery tickets with every conceivable prefix of the. That's what they've done. Because, and you're like, well, that's more money than the world. That's what they've done. They've created $1,500 trillion. And they have simply taken control of the entire planet because they get us to accept the fraud. They come in here with a magic Federal Reserve, New World Order wand, same group of banks worldwide, and they go, we give ourselves $50 trillion. We give ourselves $100 trillion. But to give it value, they then make us operate and work. I mean, people's daughters will go out. Girls that should be marrying into great families, should be writing novels, should be owning stores, should be doctors. The cream of America goes out to elite bars and restaurants and lines up to be picked up by a rich man. And they're not prostitutes. They just get given money. That's what America does because it's all based on a fraud. And I don't want my daughters growing up in a world like that. I want to turn things back towards the light. And it's all a magic wand. It's all a fraud. The only people they bust for Ponzi schemes are little low-level people like Madoff, you know, who only stole $100 million. And some of the other guys, you know, that stole $10 billion, $15 billion. And because they ran scams on other elitists. You see, oh, magic wand, all the money I want. You know, you'll go sell your body. I know a lot of people in Austin, because it's a big medical center research area of the country. I know a lot of people that buy a new car or go and pay their bills off going and signing and waiving their rights to have experiments done on them where it's lethal type stuff. I mean, it hurts them. And you can sign and waive your rights for that. I mean, America, that's what we do now. And, all right, I'm done ranting. When I come back, I want to hear what you think about Bob Costas saying we should basically ban guns. He said we'd be better off with no guns. You know, that if this guy didn't have a gun, this wouldn't have happened. As if the gun came out and did it. Okay, so I want to know your take on that. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. 2012, all that hype. Hillary getting set to run for president, you know, in 3.5 years. The Vatican putting in RFID tracker chips. The latest TSA, UN to take over the internet. It's all coming up. And Joe Rogan. Joe Rogan. We have witnessed two terrible. Yes, my friends, Alex Jones here, back live. And coming up in the next segment, I will open the phones up throughout the remainder of the transmission, interspersed with science and technology news, the economy news that I will get to. That homeless guy that the police officer bought shoes for, he doesn't have the shoes already. There's a reason some people are poor, folks, but it doesn't mean we shouldn't still help them. And we're also, there's some people you can give everything and they'll lose it all a day later. There are some people who can lose everything and have it all back a day later. Continuing, New Yorker editor, I do intend to get into that. Hillary for president. That'll be 5 Clinton administrations because they've really are running Obama as well. So we're going to be breaking all of that down and more on what's happening with the TSA. Another veteran journalist calling it rape. And that's exactly what it is. But before I get back into the Bob Costas situation and the Second Amendment and then come back and take your calls in a long segment Joe Rogan, who I've known since like 1998, number one, I think he's a really smart guy. Don't agree with all his political views, obviously, nor he. He doesn't agree with everything I do. But he's just a really nice guy. I've known him for like 14 years now. And I only get to see him a few times a year when I'm out in L.A. or when he's comes through Austin. And he's been so busy with his podcast, multiple TV shows, UFC and everything, that he's been hard to get on the radio. You know, just because when you start doing this stuff a lot, like he's doing now, I turn down most interviews. You just get burnt out. But he said, yeah, come on out to the show, go out to eat and stuff, and let's do an interview. And so I went over there, went and saw the show with, I took David Ortiz, Marcos Morales, and Rob Dew did camera. And we went over there, and it was the best interview I've ever done with Joe. Hands down, it's powerful. Because I talked to him before and after, you know, his piece. And so that is going to be airing Thursday or Friday. We'll air a radio version because obviously it's not all the King's English. And then we'll have an uncensored version for prisonplanet.tv, but we can warn people up front for that. Not that it matters, but I've got to just say that because I'm on broadcast radio. There's not too much, but there's some of it. Now, the point is, I think profanity is Bob Costas saying the gun did the murder, not the NFL player. To me, that's profanity. People saying the family is arcane and bad and the state should get rid of the family, as textbooks teach at all the major colleges. Just go look for yourself for the government systems of social workers. That's profane. Putting vaccines in kids full of cancer viruses, that's profane, not the old English word for poo-poo. But just some of my own humor there, that is coming up. But here's a quick clip from his podcast a few weeks ago, a listener sent us, where one of the guys he has on the show, one of the guys that goes on the road, I met him, pretty nice guy, he was talking about ritual is a good thing, they ought to go join the Masons. Being sarcastic, really saying, let's go infiltrate and find out what they're up to. But, I mean, Thanksgiving's a ritual. Reading your children books at night and saying their prayers is a ritual. Humans do like ritual. See, now all ritual turns into something bad. Church is a ritual. And then they make the joke that, oh, Alex is going to get mad at us saying this. And I understand the joke is of a caricature of Alex Jones, not what I really stand for. But it's pretty darn funny. It's the best Joe Rogan imitation I've ever seen him do. And he does a great one of Joey Diaz. But I think this, he really is a master at this, and he's getting better. So here's a short clip from the Joe Rogan Experience.
To go to the Masonic Lodge and be like, I want to become a Freemason. And then they do, like, background checks on you.
Should we become Masons?
Yes, let's do it. I think it'd be a blast.
What do you think is good about being a Mason?
I think ceremony is...
People are going nuts right now in front of their computer. It's... shills! These New World Order shills! Where is the Alex Jones hotline number? I need to call him!
Joe Rogan has publicly admitted on his show that he is a Mason. He has Duncan Trussell on, who talks about how wonderful it is to be a Mason and spreading propaganda, disinformation about Masons being about geometry. They're about control! They're about taking your soul, ladies and gentlemen. Not what I'm going to stand for.
Man, that is spot on. I think those are actual quotes. You know, I'm in a big Discovery Channel show. I haven't seen it yet, but people tell me it's good. I need to watch Secrets of Secret Societies. You'd think I would. I'm in a couple episodes of that. You'd think I would watch that. But again, I don't like Joe Rogan because he's a celebrity. I like him because he's my friend of a long time. And let me tell you, that's the look for Joe. He's wearing an astronaut outfit, an orange astronaut launch outfit with a shaved head. It's becoming. I'm serious. I think I may go with that look. I'm not usually I literally want to just go out and get an astronaut outfit immediately. But I'll give you my take on the Masons for real on the other side, since that video has gone particularly viral. So everybody knows where I stand. Then your phone calls on Bob Costas and the gun grabbing. It's all coming up. Prisonplanet.tv. We're streaming video right now. Stay with us. One more shot. One more vaccine. And then your child's going to have that convulsion. And that's when they do the devil dance. There. There goes your mind. There goes your brain cells. Yeah. Another vegetable. Count up another score on the scoreboard for the new world order. And who loves you and who do you love? The new world order. All right, briefly, and then I'll go to phone calls. On the whole Mason thing, and I've always explained this, it does a massive disservice to just get up on air and say the Masons are the Illuminati and they're devil worshipers and they're going to kill you and they're the ones doing everything. Because about half our founding fathers were Scottish Freemasons, Blue Lodge people. And that went back to Solomon's Temple, just to boil this down simply, when knowledge was power. Just like knowledge is power today, the formula to create diesel, the formula to crack the atom, the formula you know, to make Coca-Cola taste so good. Well, it's cocaine. It's the same thing. How to build buildings, geometry, how to construct things, how to create a royal arch. That was the most prestigious thing. Rock stars in every culture, going back more than 5,000 years, have been the people who were the master builders of the pharaohs and the Babylonians and the Chinese, the Qin, and countless others. That was the real sign, architecture. And you didn't just give that science up to anybody. So they had mystery schools that were private colleges put out by the priest class, generally affiliated with the royal dynasty, who also taught agriculture and propaganda and manipulation, and they taught people how to make the public superstitious and tell them the sun wouldn't come back if they didn't give them more power. And then the priest would say, if the Buga God is mad at you, the sun isn't going to come back, because they'd been marking down when the eclipse would come. So there's a lot of superstition, a lot of occultic. Occultic just means hidden. And that's where all of this comes out of. And that's where the Illuminati comes out of, too. But that's just history. And so George Washington was a Mason, but he was a great man. A lot of my ancestors have been Masons. You judge a tree by its fruits. Now, that said, one of my great uncles told my dad when he was a kid, don't join the Masons. And he was a high-level Mason, as high as you could get. Because so much organized crime uses the Masonic secret system and the good old boy network to be able to get away with murder. And I mean murder. And I won't get off into all of it. But Texas was founded by Masons. Most of my ancestors were Masons. And these were good people, one of my ancestors, they wanted to be the treasurer of Texas. And he wouldn't do it because he saw it as potentially immoral. But David Ayers. But the point is that Masonry itself, and George Washington wrote letters at the time about this, and they're on the Library of Congress website. Just type in George Washington letters on Illuminati. There's a bunch of them. How they, through France and the Jacobins, were taking over Masonry and were Illuminati, and that they wanted to create hell on earth. And that's what they want. They want hell on earth, burning cities, raping everybody, just death, destruction, hell. They want to pull down all the governments to then have a reign of terror and then build their new government, which is an absolute tyranny, after they destroyed the society. And the Illuminati talked about how they used the Masons, who were upset about tyranny, to actually help take over governments, and then they would take them out as well. So that's what's going on with this. And when you just come out and say Masons are devil worshippers, then people who are third-degree master Masons are all the way up to 32nd degree, and then, of course, the honorary degree of 33, it actually goes above that. They don't know all this. And yes, the Illuminati has taken over Masonry. You can argue where it came from, the different branches of it. It predates Christianity. It predates Judaism. It predates Islam. It is the old-time religion. And it is, at its base, Luciferian. But that was overtaken and Christianized, and then just used as a fraternity of engineering and science where you went and shared mathematics and things. It was the British Masonic lodges with scientists that discovered vitamin C. They didn't know what it was. They just called it a factor in in citrus fruits. And that's why they called the British limeys. And that's why they became a global dominant power with their navies, because the French and Spanish and others said, oh, you're superstitious drinking those limes, you know, in your grog, two parts water, one part rum. It's an old story. The point is, I said I'd go to your calls. So much of the Masonic Lodge is the Enlightenment, is even the Protestant Reformation, which no one can deny there was a lot of tyranny in the Vatican and a lot of corruption there. Anything that's old over time starts becoming corrupt. But then they simply overthrew that and set up their own system. So it's just, it's anything that gets too old becomes corrupt. That's it's called entropy. And I'm oversimplifying all of this, but you're not going to reach out to Masons and get them to wake up to the Illuminati by just saying, you're a devil worshiper. I know you go in there and cut the heads off of goats and rape kids. That's not going on at 99.9% of Masonic lodges. Masonic lodges are only a screening system for upper society, and you'll have lodges that are mainly scientific, or lodges that are brewers, or you'd have lodges, you know, that were military in order. Because here's the deal. People that are successful don't just want to hang around with anybody. Because as soon as you become successful, you immediately find out people want to get around you. They call it scraping an acquaintance in England, so that they can claim you've done something bad to give themselves notoriety, or so they can try to blackmail you, or so they can try to suck off of you. So whether it's low-level success or high-level success, there are more and more elite pathways, and it's all based on trust. But at the very upper end of that, it's all about trust and some really bad stuff. See, low-level, and I'm not talking about Masonic stuff here. I'm talking about business, life, fraternities, organizations, groups. That's why I always feel so sorry for people who attack me, or people that have scraped an acquaintance, been on the show a few times, stuff like that, who then go out and make it their whole life to demonize Alex Jones. I get sad, but not in the way they think. I get sad because I realize, man, that person is never going to be let into any polite society. That's why David Gergen, when I told him I'd snuck into Bohemian Grove, he said, you're not gentlemanly, and I don't appreciate that you did that. You made an agreement. And I went, no. And he goes, oh, you're the guy that crashed it. Then he knew who I was and turned red and got in my face. And he said, you're not a gentleman. You're going to pay for that in polite society. It was your blackballed, boy. Well, I'm happy to be blackballed by super upper crust, Karl Rove of five administrations, four definitely. That's one thing. But when you see, people don't get this. You blackball yourself in business or life, and there's all these losers, and they wonder why they're losers. Chief amongst losers are they're lazy. Or they're envious of someone who's successful. I've discovered that I've always been successful because I genuinely admire the strong. I genuinely admire the beautiful. I genuinely admire the handsome. I genuinely admire the intelligent. I genuinely want people to be successful. And I found that is the one of the only prerequisites in life for success on the path of being a good guy, the light side. Now, the dark side, you've got to have all those skills, but then you've also got to know how to twist things and do all these bad things, because you'll get shut down as well. But I see these people over the years that attack me and lie about me, and don't they know that all they've done is blackballed themselves? I never have to say a word about anybody to anybody. I don't gossip to anybody. I don't have time to gossip. People that are successful immediately look into someone before they associate with them in any way. It's like a bird will test a perch before it jumps up on it. And we as patriots need to not have our culture and our society poisoned by cognitive dissonance, sold by people like Cass Sunstein, who said, we'll go out and pose as alternative media conspiracy theorists and just fight with each other all day. And that's done so that there's no society there. That's done so that it is just a morass of infighting and mindlessness. And most people that play part in this, they're not even actively conscious of it. The globalists just know their psychology and know who they are. And that's what the Illuminati's doing, is taking the mystery school knowledge of Egypt, Babylon, Israel, and all these other ancient cultures, Roman, Greek. And they teach this at the higher levels of secret societies. You're not in a real secret society, even if you're a 32nd degree Mason. Because those are not just porch Masons in their degrees. They're porch Masons in the lodge that they're in itself. You know, a police officer lodge, or a plumber's lodge, or a doctor's lodge. You're not in an elite lodge. If you're in a Yale lodge, you are worshiping Satan. If you are in one of the big main national lodges, yeah, everybody there is 32nd degree or 33rd degree. And then there's degrees above that. So it's all about compartmentalization. So see, it's good to be upstanding and be in good society and to be known as someone that can be trusted. That's where everything opens up to you. Because, oh, that guy doesn't try to burn people. That guy is nice. That guy is willful and strong and stands what he believes in, but he's not twisted and just trying to bring people down for no reason. That's called being honorable. And in the power structures of the world, secret societies as well, all the way up to a certain level, it's very moral people. And that's what you'll find. The devil's carriage, as I've said many times, is pulled by the good, but the good who don't have the full picture. That's why awareness of this and how this really works will allow the power structure to be removed, because their own minions who think they're doing something for the greater good, or who have been compartmentalized or twisted, will see the full design and then understand where this road ultimately leads. Because all of the gentlemanliness and friendliness and the fact that you can be counted on as a journalist and not, you know, destroy your sources, the fact that you can be counted on, that will lead you automatically into success in life. And then once you've hit that level, there's a ceiling, because then there's actual dark controllers above that, and they will use people that are trusted, that they can trust around them. Very evil people will actually be surrounded by good people, generally, I've discovered, because they know that's who they can trust, but all those people are compartmentalized. Do you understand? And so we do a disservice by attacking fraternal organizations and things like that, because then the Masons and people get attacked and they think, well, we're just raising money for school kids. We're just helping in the community. We're just helping do this and that. How dare you say that about us? And then that discredits everything else we're talking about. So that's where I stand on the Masons. And I've gone over, but we still got over an hour and 10 minutes to take calls. When we come back, I will go directly to your calls and then calls throughout the third hour. 800-259-9231. Kathy and Phil and Fred and Brad and Tony and many others, we're going to get to you. You see, winning is all about having a superior culture. People always say, the globalists say, there are no superior cultures. And I go, okay, so I can't make cultural judgments about what type of food I like. I can't make cultural judgments just about what attracts me, what type of woman attracts me. I can't make cultural judgments about what type of laws I like. I mean, can I say the Aztecs were wrong to sacrifice tens of thousands every year to their gods? I think that was really a degenerate culture that really fell apart. Can I say the Nazis had a bad culture? Oh, of course, that's a bad culture. You see, they want to demonize the farming culture and call it backwards and stupid. They want to demonize a hunting culture, like we just want to kill things. No, we have a thing in our brain that we're supposed to go out and hunt animals. It's not about the killing them. In fact, sometimes you're sitting there and you've killed, you go, well, I better butcher this and eat it. It's something you need to do. It's bestial. And it's not bad to be animalistic at a level, because you're meant to be like that. You have to have the higher order on top of it. In fact, if you don't have your animal stuff fulfilled, you're not going to have the higher stuff fulfilled. But here's a victory. Everybody I know in the left, all over this country, is discovering firearms. They're going out, they're shooting them. Women are discovering, single women, how great it is to have a firearm. Women, on average, are better shots than men. Did you know that? Women are going hunting. Women are getting into real feminine power, not the fake CIA feminism. See, they always create a counterfeit of it. And there's all these shows now on television I've been noticing when I analyze it where the women are living up in, you know, Montana or Alaska, and they're so happy statistically. And I'm not saying everybody needs to go out and live in the woods. It's just that all the switches start getting flicked in men and women when you're living like we lived for all these eons before. Here's the Chronicle that has written cover stories on me repeatedly. Incredible lies. I mean, lawsuit city if I wanted to. I'd own them. No doubt, hands down, but I don't care because bad press is good press in the final equation, because I'm not just thinking about myself. I want to get the word out. The Chronicle has now been having pro-gun articles. The Chronicle here in Austin, the weekly paper, circulation of 160,000 a week, going the people that founded South by Southwest, who I'd like to be nice to. I don't want to sit there and going out for dinner, learning the responsibilities and rewards of getting your own game at the Dadu's Hunting School for Women. And you go to page 44, and it shows the women learning how to hunt and learning how to butcher. By the way, the meat tastes so much better. And, you know, getting guns, or they can hunt with bows. Okay, this is how we win. This is how we beat them. We take the human culture and we stack it up against the globalist artificial culture, because they have to have an artificial culture to dehumanize you, or you won't go along with their system. So all you've got to do is try to rediscover your humanity. You'll win. Folks, when the most liberal publication I know of is now pro-hunting and becoming pro-gun, we're winning. We're winning. It's starting. It's happening. We'll be right back.
This man wants your guns. That is the cover.
Okay, we got an article up at Infowars.com. I've already played the clip. I'll play it again next hour. But Bob Costas is saying, hey, if you wouldn't have had a gun, this wouldn't have happened, and we got to restrict the Second Amendment, basically. That video's up at Infowars.com. It's up at DrudgeReport.com. I'm sure you've already seen it. I'm going to go to your calls now and then start them into the next hour. But anybody that assaults our Second Amendment is bad news. It needs to be attacked politically. They want to disarm you. They want to take your claws away. They want to make you a slave. You need to take that real personal. Real personal. NBC uses NFL murder-suicide tragedy to make plea for gun control. That's up at Infowars.com via thedailycaller.com. And it's truly disgusting. Makes me sick. So I threw that out for callers. I'm going to go to your calls briefly. We're running it until December 10th. We have them in stock, something others don't have, and they're 15% off the best gravity-fed filters out there, stainless steel, four different units, 15% off with the promo code WATER15. You put WATER15 in at checkout, 15% off your order of the ProPure filters. And I would give it as a gift as well, all the stuff that's in the water, and they have fluoride filters as well. They're just heads above any competition, and we have the lowest prices. That is 15% off, and it will end December 10th, because we got so much to ship out and get out. I want to make sure you get it way before Christmas. So again, give the gift of clean water at InfoWarsStore.com or call 888-253-3139, 888-253-3139, or get your check in the mail, P.O. Box 19549, Austin, Texas 78760. And your purchase also funds the operation of what we're doing here through free association. Let's go ahead and free choice. Let's go ahead and go to Kathy in Texas on disarming the American people. Go ahead.
Good afternoon, Alex. I was having coffee when Bob Costas started his gun grab mess, and I immediately turned it off and ran for my second cup. And it reminded me of a gun protest that was going on. I think I saw it online, and a chubby fella was standing next to someone protesting guns, and he had his own little sign, and it had a drawing of a big spoon on it that you eat with. And it said, "This spoon made me fat." And I thought it was hilarious.
That's it. Guys, get me Bob Costas' address. I want everyone to mail them spoons with that. We're going to launch a protest on Bob Costas, but also the NFL, because if they fired Hank Williams Jr. for saying that Obama was turning into a tyrant when he is, then I want Bob Costas to apologize. That's all I want, to not say my guns are the fault in this country. Not everybody's rich like you. Costas can have bodyguards, and he's on record having bodyguards. That's a great idea. I want to get Watson or one of the Watsons or one of our crew to come up with an idea. $1,000 prize as well. I'm sure doing lots of little things. Whoever videotapes in the next week, you writing your letter, nothing threatening, and sending him your open letter to Bob Costas for the best letter, shooting a video of you putting a spoon with the letter to mail it to Bob Costas. We're going to launch that contest, and we're going to mail spoons to Bob Costas. That is a fantastic idea, ma'am.
Well, it's not mine. It was something I saw, and it was just so hilarious, and I said, that's exactly the analogy.
Yeah, guns causing crime is like spoons making people fat.
Right. And speaking of food, can I add this?
Sure. Switzerland has the lowest crime rate in Europe. You can look up the crime statistics from the EU. They have total armaments everywhere. I'm sorry. Go ahead, ma'am.
So, you know, guess what else they're going to use our GMO corn for instead of fuel, ethanol?
What?
Making plastics.
Well, you know, it must be good for you. Yeah, they can have GMO corn produce anything. Chemicals. They can make corn basically grow gasoline. They can make it grow HIV virus. That's pharmacological crops. Yum, yum, yum. We'll be right back. All right, we're now into the third hour. We're going to Phil, Fred, and many others that are patiently holding, Brad, Tony, Michael, and others. And we do have a lot of other news I'll get to, but let's just go back to your calls right now. Bob Costas has blamed the Second Amendment on a spoiled brat gladiator hopped up reportedly on drugs, killing himself and his girlfriend. Well, because he has bad behavior, we've got to lose our guns so criminals that have guns can have their way with us, like Chicago and New York. I'm rooting for Chicago, folks, for folks to wake up out there, and I know they are starting to wake up. Let's go ahead and talk to Phil. You're on the air.
How you doing, Nat? I wanted to talk about this Bob Costas thing. I want to start off by saying I play football myself, and it's a great game, and there's a lot of things we can learn about life from playing football. But the NFL, they've been pushing not only this gun control thing with Bob Costas, but every time you watch a game, they're always pushing the wars, pushing the military. Salute to service. I mean, it's great. It's great to say, okay, we acknowledge.
No, it's great on the surface, but it's domestic psyop operations. North Korea has pro-military stuff at their events. It is when they have a touchdown, they cut to the troops, create a Pavlovian thing where you salivate when you see troops while they're flushing the troops down the toilet.
Exactly, and you watch this. Like, oh, we want to thank them for keeping us safe. Everything is keeping us safe. Keeping us safe. Keeping us safe. Rather than, you know what I mean? It's basically teaching us that the military, it's like the rock stars. And we're supposed to worship the military rather than showing thanks for service. It's more like worship, military.
Well, but it's only worship to accept the policy of the New World Order global war.
Exactly, but last night when I saw that Bob Costas thing at halftime, I almost shut off the game. I mean, I love watching.
No, you should shut it off. Listen, they know because they track you with the TiVo and all those systems. You're being watched, what you're doing. Everyone should boycott football because of this. Listen, if you don't get hardcore with them, they're going to get hardcore with us. They're going to take our guns. They mean business. Look, they kicked Hank Williams Jr. off Monday Night Football because of his political speech. It's time for us to boycott them. I'm telling you. Turn off the game and tell other people to do it, or you're going to lose your guns. You got to get hardcore with these people. How much do you want your guns?
Of course, we need our guns. It's our last check on government. But the thing is,
but we need our football more.
Well, I play football, and I want to watch it played at the highest level. And I learn myself.
I know, but I'm saying, I know you're addicted. But my point is that you have to break the addiction. You have to really make sacrifices. Like the forebearers dragging, 100 miles, a big gun with their shoes coming off and a blood trail behind them from Ticonderoga. You've got to make the sacrifice of turning off that brainwashing thing. It's not that football's bad. It's like you go to your church and then they put government propaganda into it. It's not that there isn't something still good in the service. You've got to leave that church because they become a government operation lacing cyanide into the message. You've got to leave them is the only way to reform them. Do you understand that?
I understand. It also pays my bills, too. So, I mean, it pays my way through school and it pays.
No, listen, 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 listen. I got the. So you're a college football player.
Yes, sir.
Well, I understand at that level it's your profession, and all of us have to make decisions in our profession. You know, like, well, if I go all the way on something, I won't even be on the air. So, you know, then I'll get out as much as I can. I mean, but I don't even go with that system anymore. I just, like, I never really did. But you do have to think about what you're saying, so someone can't use it against you. Because that's one thing they do. They also distort things. But then you can't let that make you over second guess as well. God bless you, sir. It's actually formed in my head. I'm announcing a boycott of the NFL rest of the season, 2012-2013, and mailing spoons to Bob Costas. We are going to do it. We are launching it today. It's happening. It's on. Stay with us. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another hour of Worldwide Broadcast. I am your host, Alex Jones. We're going to go back to your calls. I can see everybody's really upset about Bob Costas and the NFL transmission saying that, yeah, people don't need guns. Handguns are bad. We know about the clip of the attorney general saying he met with the heads of the media to, quote, brainwash the public against the Second Amendment. Well, I'm going to shoot a video at the end of the radio show today that I'm going to post at Infowars.com. Calling for a boycott of the NFL and Bob Costas and the network that carries the Sunday night, Sunday football, NBC, because, folks, this is government propaganda. All the pro-war stuff, saying troops like war, let's be pro-military, let's be pro-war. Well, that's not pro-military, that's not pro-America. The pro-TSA propaganda, the Homeland Security consulting with them for propaganda purposes. The biggest propaganda event out there is NFL. And now, if the spokesman of it is going to demonize our precious God-given human right, civil right, constitutional right, we have to boycott them. Listen, whenever the host of Monday Night Football, the guy that introduced it, Hank Williams Jr. said that Obama is becoming a dictator, along with both parties are just horrible. And Obama was becoming and is becoming on so many fronts, whether it's handing over the internet to the UN or shutting down our coal power plants and exempting General Electric outside of Congress, or saying NATO and the UN's over our military, or signing statements in NDAA. And signing a secret cybersecurity directive and saying Congress can't see it. Congress are the bosses. They make the laws, the purse strings, the check and the balance on the president. And he said that, and folks, he said that on Fox News. He didn't say that on the NFL broadcast. And they dropped his contract. Now, Bob Costas, and I will guarantee you he got approval for that. That is the image of a sniveling establishment propagandist. Gets up there, and you want my guns, pal? I don't like you for the rest of my life. And I already don't watch football except when my family comes over for Thanksgiving or Christmas or something like that. And let me tell you, there'll never be any football on in my house as long as I'm alive. Until the NFL is not fully in the hands of the globalist as a propaganda tool. Don't you know in North Korea and communist China and in Hitler's Germany, sports were used as propaganda venues? It stops now. And I had a football player call in earlier, a college football player, and he said, well, it's paying for my college, paying for my family. He said, I don't like that propaganda. I know it's propaganda and it's wrong, but I'm going to keep watching. I almost turned it off. And his voice almost shook. You almost turned your God off. I used to watch the NFL games. Even when I was going to college and hanging out with my buddies. You know, I like football. I played football in high school. I get it. But it's sick now. It's been taken over. Vaccine ads, anti-family ads, anti-gun stuff. You got to get rough with these people. Look, I asked him, I said, do you like your Second Amendment or your football more? And the caller said, well, I'm actually a player, so in college it pays for everything, so that's what I choose. See, at least he's honest about it. You're going to lose the Second Amendment. You're going to lose it all unless you start taking it personal. We're the majority, constitutional libertarian types. Every actuary out there, we're about 55, 60% of the country. But we don't exercise any of our power. We just let ourselves be run over. I'm calling on you to help me. I'll get a press release out today, but I'm calling on the media to help us out there, the Patriot media out there. We've got to call for a boycott of the NFL. And believe me, it'll hurt them if just 5% of viewers tune it out. If we can get Gun Owners of America behind this, if we can get the NRA, it's over, folks. The NFL will apologize for taking a tragic event, some reportedly drugged up, spoiled brat, 25-year-old punk who kills himself and his girlfriend. And because he's out of his mind, we need to turn our guns in. So if somebody commits a crime with a knife, do I have to turn my butcher knives in? England's actually calling for that. If somebody robs a bank in my city, do I go to jail too? That's authoritarian. Hey, cops shoot innocent people all the time. Do we take all the government's guns? Oh, no, no, no. Predators bomb the wrong people all the time in their drone war. Oh, no, no, they don't get rid of that. Oh, the military tortures people to death. Do we shut down the whole military? I'm sick of this idea. The highest crime is New York and Chicago because they've taken the people's guns. Same thing, L.A.'s got draconian laws. Everywhere they take the guns, more crime, more crime, more crime. A street artist put up, it's in the New York Daily News, put up posters showing, you know, a drone attacking pedestrians. Tastefully done, just a cutaway of a family with a drone flying over him. They arrested him and are charging him with felonies. Because when they broke in his house, he had a .22 revolver. You'd be crazy to live in New York City and not have a gun. You'd be out of your mind to live in Chicago and not have a gun. In fact, I want to go up to Chicago and see all their great museums and the history. I've been there before. I want to drive up there in my RV, broadcast from there. But I'm like, wait, I look at states, and it's not Illinois itself, but it's the city. Do I, like, have to park my RV outside Chicago and then drive in, and then will I be with my children and not have a gun? I mean, it's just, it's incredible that we put up with this. By the way, speaking of Chicago, then I'm going to your phone calls. Every week, at least, I'm going to start plugging on the Sunday show, so twice a week, our Sunday affiliates and our weekday affiliates during the week. And we've got over 140 AM and FM affiliates now. We're gaining 3 or 4 a week, sometimes more. And some of these are 50,000 waters and stuff. Like Bakersfield, California turns us on this week. That thing covers the whole state, and it's got huge ratings already. The fact that we're exploding like this is an absolute godsend, okay? And I'm going to do the best job I can up here. But I've been on and off Chicago a few times over the years, had a huge response. But, you know, you're on a few years, the station goes sports, or the station sells. I mean, I was on a fellow station in Chicago. Was it WJJG, like in 1998 and 99. And that thing had so many listeners, it was probably like 30% of our audience back then. You know, the 30 or so affiliates. So I think I had more than that back then because I actually went up to about 100 and then went back down for a while. The point is that I wanted to plug, and every week I'll have a station in focus, WCKGChicago.com, WCKGChicago.com. And everybody should go to that site. You can also get their free iPhone, smartphone apps and hear all their shows and get their podcast and support them, sponsor them. 1530 AM WCKG. Let's say you listen in Chicago or Illinois. Let's say you're listening to the free iPhone app I've got, or you're listening to the audio streams or watching the streams at PrisonPlanet.tv. It doesn't matter. Tell 5 people a day about AM 1530 WCKG. Covers all of Chicago. Absolutely fantastic. We're on there with Mancow. He's on in the morning. He's now got a TV show getting huge ratings there. They're simulcasting his radio show. That's really the model for the nighttime show. That's where we're going. So I've had some national networks talk to me and swear up and down that I wouldn't have to be censored or pre-approved. In fact, I was approached and offered the deal, and I just said, I don't believe it. I think down the road you try to restrict me. They want me to do like a 2-hour show late at night, like Imus in the morning, and it was just immediately going to be put on to millions of people. But I'm just like, I can't quit the daytime show. I mean, I just cannot work all the time. So I don't think the crew even knew about that, but there, I've thrown that out there. I was approached by Sci-Fi and a couple others. I mean, I just, you know, Ventura was told by True TV he'd be allowed to do whatever he wanted. By the first season, it already started. Second season, they were censoring shows. Third season, they totally took it and butchered it one side and down the other. And but by the way, before I go to your calls on that subject, Jesse called us. He had to get on a train to go cover some incredible information in Chicago outside of his show. This was so big. And I will tell you, it's the mistress of Lee Harvey Oswald, who we're going to get back on the show. And McBreen interviewed her, what, last week? 2 weeks ago? When was it? A couple weeks ago? It was a couple weeks ago. So he's doing that right now. He'll be on sometime this week for his update. But there's that information. But WCKGChicago.com. And if you're a local business there and want to call their manager and sponsor the broadcast, 630-426-3538. And we are going to plug every single affiliate we've got. Every week, it'll be a new station in focus. I need to do two or three a week, though, or we'll never get through 140 affiliates a year. Yeah, that should be our goal, that we... Maybe we should have like two or three stations twice a week in focus real fast, but I'll have to pre-write it up or I'll start blabbing about it for like an hour and run out of time. Okay, so there you go. I'm going to take you out to break with Bob Costas, who wants your guns. They're going to hijack a tragedy to take our guns. And I take it personal. It is personal, Costa. I've never liked you, you little piece of trash. I don't like you. Look like a little sneaky, know-it-all, corporate, play-it-safe scumbag. You're not going to get my guns, you un-American filth. And stop using tragedies to get my guns. Here's scumbag Bob Costas. Here it is.
Our current gun culture, Whitlock wrote, ensures that more and more domestic disputes will end in the ultimate tragedy.
Shut up, scum.
And that more convenience store confrontations over loud music coming from a car will leave more teenage boys bloodied and
dead. People get more polite.
Handguns do not enhance our safety. They exacerbate our flaws, tempt us to escalate arguments, and bait us into embracing confrontation rather than avoiding it.
That's enough. He goes on for more restrictions. Ladies and gentlemen, the cities where they take the guns is where the gangbangers are killing everybody. Out in the country, people are polite. An armed culture is a polite culture, and that's been proven. Switzerland, they have hand grenades, not just machine guns, and they have the lowest crime rate in Europe and a lot better than ours. England's crime rate's exploded since they took guns. We don't want to live in your gun-free slave zone, bud. With the government ruling over us, they got the guns, we have nothing. Unbelievable. Our gun culture is defeating you, Costas, and we're going to defeat you and the Homeland Security running man, NFL gladiatorial crud.
Sodium fluoride in the body.
Okay, coming up in the next segment, I'm going to give you the contact information for the Rockefeller NBC Sports, Rockefeller Center, of course. Right next to the UN, it's people know. Right across the street from Rockefeller Center, they have a big gun tied in a knot. I mean, that's what we're dealing with here. Let's go back to your calls here now. The NFL spokesman says you need to turn your guns in. And I'm good old boys that probably go turn them in now. And they told them, you know, kill your children for the NFL. They might do it. Well, not me. Tony in Missouri, you're on the air. What's your take on this? Well, Tony, that sounds pretty darn interesting. Go ahead, Tony. I'm being sarcastic. Tony, anything else? Okay, let's go to Fred in Idaho. What's your take on it?
Hi, Alex. Thanks for taking my call, and many blessings to you and yours. What part of shall not be infringed do these people not understand? We have one of the most powerful, and we're blessed with, you know, one of the greatest documents ever in the history of mankind. And it says, Article 2, shall not be infringed.
Well, and it also says Congress shall make no law respecting the establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof or the press or the people's right to peaceably assemble for a redress of grievance. But they are running it all over. And I got news, Bob Costa, and I guarantee he was told to say that. Shut up and leave my rights alone, you little authoritarian pig. Go ahead.
Yeah, Alex, it's our fault, and it's not his fault. I mean, I go for it. Do away with people should not watch NFL football, obviously, because the powers that be have said, go ahead and do this. But listen, We can solve these problems. It is right there in that document. It is in our laws. You know, we can don't watch football. But what we need to do is attack these people where they live and breathe. And I have a solution to the TSA problem. I'd like to challenge people to go out and do this. The TSA is violating our Fourth Amendment rights. I think we can all agree on that.
And lying to us and saying we can't film them and acting like drama queens like we've done. Like, you don't like me sticking my hands in your wife's pants and into her body? Why, are you with Al-Qaeda? No, the criminal government you work for runs Al-Qaeda publicly, you little scumbag. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Right. So, here's the answer. Here's the solution. People, you're listening. Do this. I'm doing this. There is a thing called a quo warranto. It's a writ. And the TSA is under contract to each of these airports throughout our country. The airport and the airport authorities are the people that are responsible.
That's right. You can sue the airport authority. There's more than one way to skin a cat when they violate your rights. And they claim this immunity. It's a fraud. Take it to court. Challenge it.
Take it to court and issue a writ of quo warranto and sue them and take away their franchises. The county of Albany, I was watching your video on that officer and Bravo. But who was the guy standing there telling
them? He was the airport authority head. And I see people in that viral YouTube video that Jason Burmison crew shot for us. And I see them in that video. People are like, this is private property. Of course they can deny it. No, it's not. You're operating it as a public commons where the Bill of Rights and Constitution operates. And if any tax money goes to the building of the facility, you cannot stop filming. They can call it their policy all day long. It's incredible how they're trying to tell people they can't videotape their own backyards now. And he tells the cop and winks at him. He says, I want his ID. And Jason Burmese is going, I'm Jason Burmese. And he goes, I don't believe that. Get it for me. Wink, wink. And the cop's like, if I don't think he's doing something wrong, I don't have probable cause, I can't ask for it. Yes, police can demand your ID. Doesn't mean you have to have one. You can't be arrested for failure ID if it's not on you. But they can ask you who you are and ask for it to see if it's there if they believe that you're involved in the commission of a crime. It's called probable cause. And then they've got to be able to say in court what the probable cause was or what the reasonable suspicion was. That's the bare minimum. But you pull up to a checkpoint and cops want to see your ID and smell for alcohol. That's not reasonable suspicion. That's, hey, Dragnet, Nazi Germany, we're going to check everybody. Listen, we got to start seeing Bob Costas and these people not as liberals that mean well. This is a dirtbag in a globalist Homeland Security, Pentagon, domestic intelligence manipulation program. They admit it's going on, saying they want our guns. That was the Pentagon, run by foreign banks, saying, we're coming after your handguns. We're breaking the ice on semi-autos, on the NFL. We're coming for your guns.
We're on the
wrong time. Run on.
You see, the power structure is being defeated in the gun culture. They're trying to dismantle the economy, shut everything down, ship our jobs overseas, poison our food and our water, shoot us up full of brain-damaging vaccines so they can control us. We were the old free Americans that wouldn't be slaves. We were the people that demanded the lowest taxes and the most freedom. We produced most of the world's wealth. We were those wild and crazy Americans who came here through slavery and through adversity and as sharecroppers and as inventors and as swashbucklers and freebooters, as trailblazers. And so we're hit with chemical warfare. The White House science czar admits it. They sit back and poison us. We're now brain damaged, stumbling around in a haze. But we've still got that vestigial Second Amendment laid down as an emergency century against tyranny. And people know instinctively it's happening, so they're out there buying 3, 4, 5 million guns a month, ammo, they're training, they're getting ready. Suddenly the left is buying guns. It's a huge craze. Everybody I know that used to be leftist now come up to me and apologize, and they still got their dreadlocks and their, you know, everything else. I don't care what you look like. I'm not judging you because of that. They're like, you're right, collectivism's a way to enslave us, but what do you do once they've already shipped all the jobs out and made people poor? Do they just starve? These are all the debates we have to have, but at least recognize that the collectivism was done to hurt people and disenfranchise them and reduce them down to absolute dependency. And so when Bob Costas comes out and looks in the camera and says, it's time to get rid of the handguns, that's going to be the attack. The Second Amendment, they're going after the handguns and the rifles. Obama has said it in the debates. The Attorney General has said it. They're coming. And they've said they're going to do it outside of law. Let me say that again. Alert, 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 outside of law. Now, let me give you the mailing address for Rockefeller Center, right across 30 Rockefeller Plazas, right across the street from the UN building, where they've got the handgun, the revolver, the Smith & Wesson 357 Magnum tied to a knot. And there's just other stuff everywhere, guns chopped. Of course, there's helicopters flying over and police with machine guns. Oh, they're going to have guns so they can tell you what you're going to eat and what you're going to teach your kids and what shots you're going to take, because Daddy Bloomberg knows best. And let me tell you, these would-be total controllers hate the fact that we know them, we see them, we understand we've been taken over by foreign banks, and that message is spreading. So they're like, hey, have the NFL come out and call for their guns to be taken. And if we don't stand up and say this is tyranny, they fired Hank Williams Jr., for telling the truth, God bless him. They fired him on another show. He talked about it, and he was fired after decades. What, 15 years of Monday Night Football? Gone. Are you ready for some football? You know, and of course, they've made what Monday Night Football paid anyway, so that's a good thing. Less people are brainwashed by it. But they want to still have some of it free to the general public so they can brainwash, and that's the Sunday football. And so we had to have Bob Costas sit up there and lecture us. So let me give you their address. And we actually found the number. We're going to give that out as well. NBCSports.com, National Broadcasting Company, Inc., 30 Rockefeller, I'm going to get your gun center, New York, New York. And you need to write up a nice, friendly, non-threatening letter and just say, blaming guns for crime is like blaming spoons for obesity, as many people have said, or is like naming knives for, you know, people being stabbed, and say, we don't like what Bob Costas did, and we're going to boycott the NFL and other NBC shows. We want an apology. Hey, we're not cold-blooded like the globalists, you know, firing old Hank Williams Jr., Bocephus. We just want that little creature to come out and admit he was told to say that, which we know he was. They wouldn't say something political like that if they weren't. That's why they've got him up there, the little safe pitch man to perch and look conservative and sit there and stab America in the gut. Put up the phone number for people, please. I want to be able to also give that out here on air for everybody. It's on their site, so I think we can give it out. John Bounds in there calling the number to double-check it, even though it's on their site. We want to make sure we're giving the right number out. Is that number correct? Oh, they're always changing it. Okay, well, good job. But we're going to find NBC's phone number. They hide it well. And then we're going to give out their phone number. And I certainly hope that they enjoy it. But call your NBC-owned affiliates, and tell them you don't like it as well. If you're a local sponsor of a local NBC affiliate, you call them and you say, hey, I'm going to pull my sponsorship. Hey, they want to take your guns. They're getting ready and testing the water. This is going to start a civil war if they try it. That's a big trial balloon. We got to hammer them hard. And let me tell you, if you won't boycott it until they apologize, if you won't pull your advertising, you're an idiot. And I don't get up here, boycott this, boycott that lightly. Our guns, man, that is it. And our free speech. Unbelievable. So National Broadcasting Company, Inc., 30 Rockefeller Plaza, New York, New York. Start sending the spoons today. Overnight them, man. Spoons. Send them a letter. Videotape loading the spoon. Your letter. Read your letter on video. Put it on YouTube. $1,000 to the best letter. The best letter and video that's posted. And we'll have that prize. We'll announce that December 21st when the world supposedly ends. So I won't have to pay the money. That's a joke. I always pay the prizes. That'll be a $1,000 prize, best letter and video shot of it, and the best drone this Saturday coming up at the Silker Park in Austin, Texas. Best legal, lawful drone below 400 feet, best video of that. So there you go. Enough from me. Let's go back to your phone calls. I get madder and madder the more I think about this, and it fits into their whole gun grab. Yes, sir. You have his fan mail address? Yeah, please. Please give us the fan mail address on screen. Okay, that's William Morris Endeavor Entertainment. And people can, there's a bunch of addresses there. Third floor, Beverly Hills, California, 90210-5313 USA. 9601 Wilshire Boulevard, third floor, Beverly Hills, California, 90210-5213 USA. Good. Print all that off for me because I'm going to shoot a special report for the nightly news on that tonight. Okay, enough of me. Let's go to your phone calls. Brad, are you mad about this or do you think it's good the White House is announcing they plan to not pass a law but to just order all semi-autos turned in as an executive order? Is that making you excited?
It makes me excited to the point. I can't wait to see how they figure they carry that out. That could be interesting.
Well, they'll send out cops.
I don't know of any cops around my little town that'll do it. So,
well, that means they're going to be that means they're going to be living to be old men, doesn't it?
Yeah. Hey, I wanted to on that Jovan Belcher thing. If you want to look behind the curtain, really see what's going on here. A friend of mine was in Kansas City Sports Radio, and he told me that this Belcher has been suffering from extreme headaches from concussions. And I think this is just a smokescreen to get us talking about the Second Amendment from what's really going on. He killed himself because of the headaches, just like Junior Seau did here about a year ago. And he just he couldn't handle it anymore. Unfortunately, he didn't have the maturity just to take himself out, and why do you have to take out somebody else? But I think this is the big story is going to be the concussions. You talked about the U.S. flushing the troops down the drain. I think the NFL is flushing the guys down the drain with the head injuries.
You know, I agree with you, and they've had every manner of distractions over the concussions, like the bounties with the Saints and all the rest of it. It is quite a soap opera. I'll admit, I don't watch football anymore, but I kind of follow the soap opera of the whole thing a little bit. You know, I'm driving in the car, going through the channels, I'll kind of follow it a bit, or when family's over, we watch a game sometimes, and I can sit there and enjoy a game. I mean, I just being bombarded by propaganda during the ads is upsetting. And I'm sick of it. But all that is, again, like, I want to say something here on air. I don't want to say I went off half-cocked, but I thought of what you're saying this morning. And I meant to come on air and say that. But what happens is I get on air and about 90% of my IQ goes out the window. I mean, that happens to everybody because there's so much happening that I kind of just automatically segment what I was going to say. And what I meant to get up here today and say is this. This guy had a bunch of concussions. He was admittedly on psychotropic drugs. The psychotropics are admitted to make you have psychotic breaks and not have impulse control. So this is a story of gladiators that are brain damaged on deadly psychotropic drugs that are known to cause violent outbreaks, psychotic behavior, megalomaniacal behavior. It's all on the Prozac and that whole family of drug inserts. They knew this in the trials in 1981 with Eli Lilly and Prozac. They'd had trials for 3 years before. A massive increase. It was a 17-fold increase in statistical suicide. So there it is. Chiefs linebacker struggled with head injuries, alcohol, and painkillers before he snapped and killed girlfriends. So, yeah, and I'll guarantee you he was on Prozac and or some of those same type of drugs. Probably out of his mind, and I call him insecure. I call him a murderer. You don't know when you're brain damaged on a bunch of drugs. So, yeah. I mean, I guess we can say, well, he's a product of this, just like the soldiers you can't really blame many times, who served 6, 7, 8, 9 tours and are on Prozac. Kind of like the guy that went and killed 18 Afghans. Turned out he was on those drugs, as I predicted. It's the same thing. But no, it's not the drugs. It's not the concussions to blame. It's not even him to blame. It's the Second Amendment inanimate firearm. And that's what makes me so mad. So I will put that in my point. My issue is the scapegoating of the Second Amendment by the NFL. Do you agree we've got to get angry about this and make a big deal out of it?
Oh, yeah. I'd like to make a T-shirt that says, do you think Nicole Brown Simpson wishes she had a concealed carry permit and a Ruger LC9 at her hip when she saw OJ that night?
Oh, my gosh. I'm going to take that and put it in the report. You callers just are geniuses. Exactly. Yeah. I mean, you got the knife, and they think OJ did it. Who knows? The point is that, boy, you know, it'd been really nice there in Los Angeles where they've disarmed the people. I mean, you know, somebody comes up to me with a knife, number one, I know how to fight them a little bit. But number two, you know what? Most of the time I'm packing. That's like, oh, you brought a knife to a gunfight. That's going to work out well. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Oh, that's fine. But yeah, Nicole Brown Simpson and was it Ron Goldman? I think if either of them been caring, we'd avoided 6 months of bad television at least. So, but it would have turned out a heck of a lot different.
You're an absolute genius. Okay, thank you so much. Great points. Wow, these callers. Let's talk to Michael in Kentucky. You're on the air. Welcome.
Alex.
Yes, sir.
Bob Costas is a minion. He is a joker sitting in a jester suit at the Colosseum while Rome is falling apart, just waiting and helping our country to fall down by saying these stupid comments.
Yes, absolutely. And believe me, they may try to go at the guns. They're bold. They're saying the UN runs our military. They're saying Obama can shut down the internet without congressional law. That would be unconstitutional. They're doing it all. And they are planning to try to ban semi-autos. They're going to start with registering. And they're going to go out and burn and scare people and have shootouts with people. They're going to start a civil war. And they're going to sit back while the police and military get destroyed. And that's the globalist plan, is to have us kill each other. Does that little, I agree, but we have to now go after Costas so the other minions won't follow orders. You understand?
Steve Quayle was on your show this summer, and he said something quite interesting. And I know you've heard of a Kentucky long rifle before, Alex. We are the pioneer state, Kentucky. And if the globalists come out hard, if you see Kentucky fall, you know they're coming out hard.
I hear you. Good old Kentucky long rifle. Of course I know what that is. You're talking about Davy Crockett. And all right, let's go ahead now and talk to Jack in Michigan. Jack, you ready to turn your guns in? Because the NFL said so. It's manly. Turn your guns in.
I'm going to have them all after they get my bullets. Anyways, I wanted to call just because this morning listening to talk radio, they were ranting and raving about gun culture with the NFL, and I had to get on the phone and, you know, point out that the one thing common to all of this is the pharmaceutical drugs, and why aren't they being blamed? And after that phone call, they said, well, we can't look at the drugs and the alcohol. We have to look at the person. So it clearly is their chance to go after the guns.
Yeah, they're not going after the concussions, they're not going after the prescription drugs, they're going after our guns, and Hank Williams Jr. fired for saying it on another network. This is during the football game.
Well, I truly believe the NFL is a globalist-controlled network to get control of the sports junkies and, you know, they're feeling them
up. You're saying the ESPN people were regurgitating this?
Oh, yeah. They were regurgitating over and over and over again how, you know, there's a culture of guns in the NFL, and it's all these guns, and they all have these guns, and they're all, you know, without
the guns. No. What it is, see, it's not the gun culture. There's a gangster thug life culture in the NFL. There's a pit bull, you know, all that stuff. It's a thug culture.
Yeah, and, you know, it was just funny until I pointed out, hey, pharmaceuticals could be the issue here. Let's look at that. Then it was, no, let's just look at the person. It's all about the individual.
Well, let me tell you something. It isn't going to fly with football fans. Most of them are constitutionalists or libertarians. I mean, you know, trendies don't even like watching simulated combat. And so this is not going to go over well. Listen, I'm coming out against the NFL full time now. I should have done it a long time. It is on. It is on. Let me tell you something. They don't get slapped down on this, they're going to go all the way. They've got a 100-yard drive against us, and we've got to smash them and hold them right where they are, to use an NFL analogy. Good to hear from you. Chad in Kentucky. A lot of calls from Kentucky. Go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, Alex, love listening to you, but coming on the guns, one thing that I was thinking about, they've been doing a lot of studies with these NFL players and their concussions. What if they did something with the PTSD and the soldiers, and then made you, when you registered for a gun, had to fill out if you've had a concussion or looked at your medical history.
No. That's the plan. They're going to medicalize everything and just say it's not if you're a felon now. We'll just say you've got a mental problem, and they want to now diagnose from afar and say you're just on a no-gun buy list. You've never been to a psychologist, nothing. They just say you're crazy, as they've had Psychology Today say about me, an admitted Clinton operative, had a cover story how I'm insane because I believe in a world government. And I'm on the phone with the guy going, well, here's proof of world government, and he'd laugh at me. I've had Nightline here, and I'm like, let me just show you world government documents. Oh, no, we don't want to look at those. Well, here's a clip of the head of the EU saying world government. Well, he means a different world government than what you mean. So it's all like this game. They'll never even recognize. Look, if you caught a criminal coming out your back door, a lot of criminals are smart now. They'll say, oh, I'm a workman. And they're like, no, you're robbing. No, I'm not. Hey, how you doing? And a lot of folks will actually stand down and let the guy walk off. Because you tell somebody, hey, I'm a pink giraffe. You're like, no, you're not. Yeah, I am. And people are so programmed, they go, okay. You're a pink giraffe. Wow, are you from Africa? They have pink giraffes? And you're like, yes, I am one. And the government loves you. Now take your vaccines and everything's fine. I mean, come on. Sodium fluoride in the... I'm here, and I'm telling you, look at this. Man killed father in Wyoming bow and arrow attack. And so he shot him in front of the computer science class not long after fatally stabbing his father's live-in girlfriend at their home a couple of miles away. And this is out of USA Today. Today. So ban bows and arrows immediately and ban knives. Man, I am so sick of it. I am so tired of the globalists trying to take our guns. Again, because once they get the guns, folks, they're going to come after everybody. And it's the gun culture that's defeating them. And that's why they're attacking the gun culture. They're trying to say our culture is a bunch of brain-damaged, drugged-out NFL players who run around and have pit bull fights and, you know, we're all into this. And it's not just the black NFL players. I've been into big Hollywood parties and all this stuff. And I've seen, I mean, it is, I know major directors that talk like gangsters and have tattoos all over them. And I'm like, what is this affectation? I can't suddenly say that word. What is it? It's fake. And it's just like, I mean, I'll be, because I'm not a violent person. I'm not looking for trouble. But I got my switches. And I mean, it happens all the time where I'm walking along somewhere, especially with my family, and there'll be some punk teenager with a pit bull, like with it at you, like it's scaring you. And I'm like a normal human, primitive. I'm automatically just wanting to just grab the gun, start slamming it, you know. I mean, I'm literally just have killer instinct like I should because I'm loving. And you know, these guys are all wimps, man, shooting each other and doing all this stuff. Because they're doing bad doesn't mean I'm going to lose my guns. You understand that? I'm in control of my guns. And I don't need a gun up close to kill you, I'll tell you right now. And I'm not bragging. It's easy to kill people, ladies and gentlemen. You just don't hold so. You don't hold back, you will kill people. And you'll kill them fast. It's easy to kill people. And I'm just sick of all these punks running around acting tough all day. I've had enough of it. Makes me want to throw up. Excuse me. I started having flashbacks. It's happened like 5 or 6 times. One time I'm walking. My son is like 6 months old. We're in the neighborhood. Kind of a blue-collar neighborhood, not really, kind of a lower-middle-class neighborhood at the time, but it had some scummy people in it. And it's like noon on a Saturday, and all of a sudden this giant black pit bull comes running out of a guy's garage, up, not even barking like it's going to bite me, and then starts growling. And I'm walking on the sidewalk, and my problem is I'll turn the other cheek one time. I start pushing the stroller out in the street, and the guy is laughing. And so my wife called it silverback gorilla behavior. I turned, ran up, and a lot of pit bulls are really mean. This dog ran back in. The guy's like, hey, what are you doing to my dog? I go, you were laughing, punk. Come out here, and I'll stomp you and your dog's head in. You know, and my problem is I'm not a tough guy. I don't act tough until I'm about to attack you, is my point. And yes, I don't like this thug culture either. And see, that's my problem. That's my problem is they're going, and your problem, they're going to try to blame this thug culture, this the men that don't even get in fist fights with each other. They shoot each other now. This ninny culture where you're a man because you've got a gun and you're going to go out and shoot somebody. And you see it in the rapper culture where they go shoot each other at bars because they're gangsters. And it's because everybody's being sent to prison now, and that's the new college in America. And they put them in racial areas to make you join a racial gang. The government wants all this division, and it just makes me want to throw up. We're going to go to Overdrive and talk to Wesley in Indiana. I'm going to give each caller about a minute when we come back. I'm going to race through Wesley, and I'm going to race through Chris and Spence, and I'll try to go to Kyle and others. Don't forget, I told you they're coming after your guns. That's why the new issue of InfoWars magazine, you can buy at cost in groups of 10 up to 100. That's why you can buy, it says, this man wants your guns and breaks it all down. Color glossy magazine. You can also give gift subscriptions. It's about to sell out. InfoWars.com. Get it today. You're listening to Real Talk Radio, and I'm your host, Alex Jones. It is InfoWars, a war on for your mind. By the way, I was just plugging it at the end of the last hour, about a 10-second plug. We are selling out of more than 30,000 of these we held back. I held back more than I usually do when I put them on the streets of Austin as a beta test towards syndication nationwide and worldwide, and we're getting ready for that in the new year. And it's been a big success so far. Print 2.0, try to internet kill switch this. You can buy these in groups of 10 up to 100, and it's like a color book to wake up people to why the globalists want our guns. And this new December issue is about to sell out in bulk. You will still be able to get it via the December subscription if you sign up for a yearly subscription. It's also a great gift to give people. Get on the offensive for the Second Amendment, folks, or lose it. InfoWarsStore.com. Okay, let's go to calls. Wesley in Indiana. So the NFL says turn your guns in. They're helping open up the first salvo for Obama and the coming after our guns. What do you say to that?
Well, I'm just wanting to say that I talked with a full-bird colonel who had retired from the infantry, and he was saying that they were having problems in Afghanistan, in Iraq, because when they first started to go in and get the guns, they could find them in the house. But the people that were getting their guns seized figured out if they had an AK-47, they could bury it in the ground and dig it up, and then it'll still fire. And I'm just wondering if a lot of people in America have their M16s or whatever version of that and look
down. Do daisies grow in the spring? Do bears go potty in the woods?
I guess.
Do birds fly south for the winter?
Yeah.
You bet your boots, buddy. People are ready for war. And that's part of the plan. They're going to launch the police and military against us, and that's to wipe them out and us. They'll do it. I mean, they want it. I'm sorry, go ahead, sir. The globalists hate us so bad. They want to really take their time with the re-education camps and the mass arrests and the forced labor and the torturing our kids. But the guns stand in their way, and they just hate it. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Well, I just want to say one other thing, is that you are kind of like the canary in the mine. And as long as you're on the air, it's still not too late for patriots to, stand up for the Constitution.
No, I agree with that. We are canary in the coal mine. I do not like being the canary in the coal mine, but hey, it's a job I got to do. Spence in Missouri, you're on the air, sir. Are you ready to turn your guns in? Because the Justice Department run NFL, the modern running man program, says your guns are evil.
Well, may I tell you what? I have quit watching football. I couldn't tell you how many years ago. And it just makes me absolutely sick to the pit of my stomach. To be able to, it's deer season here right now, and, there's a lot of hunters around, not as many as it has been in the past, but, everybody's working on that gerbil wheel, and nobody's got the time hardly to do it anymore, but I make the time and go do it, and I really enjoy it. I've been doing it ever since I was a young kid, my dad was alive, but I tell you, I don't live too far from that last show that Jesse Ventura just did, up here in the Ozarks, where we've got that, the house that I'm talking about?
Yeah, the giant government command center, NSA front.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. I've watched that thing go up over the last couple of years. And, just wondered. Can't get near it. This gun control issue is they're going to try every means that they possibly can to try to get these weapons from us. I can tell you that from the heart of the Ozarks right here, and I'm just north of Branson, Missouri. Got friends that work in retail in different outlets where guns are sold, and I can tell you, one particular store I'm gonna tell you has gone from the day before the election was 30 or so guns a day jumped up to over 60 a day at one store. Can't keep ammunition on the shelves. People know that this is coming.
Oh, listen, and we have a criminal foreign government run by people that have set up re-education camps because they want to get real Americans in dungeons and rip our teeth out with pliers. People are like, well, that sounds crazy. What do every other government do? These are murdering scumbag criminals, and they're going to use the NFL now to try to get our guns. God bless you. Absolutely. Our gun culture will defeat them. Guns, 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 guns. Sodium fluoride in